critican, para aquellos que usan las armas, para aquellos que nos contaminan, para aquellos que hacen la guerra, para aquellos que viven pecando, para aquellos que nos maltratan, para aquellos que nos contagian.
With the 14th selection of the 2011 first-year player draft, the Florida Marlins select José Fernández.
Watch the fluidness of his delivery. I was nervous when they shot at me. I won't be nervous facing David Wright. Fly ball right field. Did pretty well. Stanton back. Shy of the track. Makes the catch. 1-2-3 inning for José Fernández in his major league debut. As he's there's the defector. The breaking ball. But he was on the same ball that escaped with Kendrys Morales a few years before Fernández. And Fernández. And a 97 mile an hour fastball. Here's the 0-2 pitch with Fulham Express. 97 miles an hour. 1-2 coming. Well, he has two strikes. Two. Breaking ball, struck him out. Corner there, strikeout number 7. Got him. Strikeout of Bird, number 8.
So he has now established a new club record by a rookie. You could come up with so many adjectives to describe what José did today, but just great to be here and to see it firsthand.
Went out there talking to my mom that I was trying to give a chance for me to win the game and trying to have fun out there.
Nervous at all?
Not really. Not at all. I don't think I was nervous at all.
Not even, when you get ready to throw that first pitch and the crowd and everything gets going, you can get a little nervous?
I was more nervous when I was warming up in the bullpen than when I was batting mom. Yeah, but it was fun.
What emotions did you feel out there, getting out there for the first time?
I think that after the first pitch, I kind of, got it in. All right, it's the first start of the big league. So I wasn't trying to, think it was a big deal. I was just trying to be out there and try to do the best I can.
To get a first out, to get through that first inning, what did that mean for you?
I was good. Yeah, I was a good finish. I was like, okay, 3 pop-ups, and I was like, all right, now I'm going to try to keep throwing strikes and keep trying to make good pitches.
Your first strikeout ball, where do you think that's going to come? You give it to your mom, you're going to save that one?
I don't know. I don't know if they have it. Hopefully they do, but yeah, I don't know. It will be a mouse.
Is that a big confidence boost, though, when you're able to strike out guys like David Wright and go through a lineup of big league hitters? You knew you could do it at the Class A level, but this is the major leagues, and you just picked up right where you left off.
Yeah, like I said, I tried to go out there and, you know, make good pitches, and David Wright makes some good pitches, so that was the plan.
Did you ever, are you so focused that you never picked out your mom or anybody else in the stands at all during the game?
No, I don't even know where they were.
Yeah.
When you come on the field, do you look like you hopped over the third base line?
Yeah, I do it every time.
Just a little ritual? Or?
Yeah, every time I tried to do that, going over there and coming back to it. So.
Came charging from his third base spot after Fernandez, who was talking to McCann, and now the bullpen's empty as well. Johnson being separated. You see Chad Qualls has a hand on him.
So that tells us, Rich, who it was that was getting the attention of Jose last inning. It was Chris Johnson. And then Jose set it off by standing at the plate and admiring the home run.
Johnson is still going nuts right now. Well, Fernandez finally hits a home run. So he watched it. And that may have set Johnson off even more right there.
It did. Now, Jose did some 21-year-old things during that sequence. Chris Johnson's from a baseball background. He understands that whole thing. And Jose, yeah, he acted like a kid in that situation. He paused, he watched the home run, shouldn't have done that when he ran around third. Little look at the ground, looked like he spit, didn't spit toward Johnson. And that set off Johnson. And then I think McCann is just trying to say, hey kid, you just don't do that up here.
I don't understand Johnson running in from third base. Watch Johnson from third.
The most important person in my life that I would love her, you know, I would love for her to see me pitch in the big leagues. It will be my grandma. She's in Cuba. Unfortunately, she's not allowed to come here, or she can't. But I mean, that will be the person that will make my, that will make me really happy to be here and watch me pitch.
And how about the story on how he got here? Defected from Cuba three times. First two times got arrested. Third time almost made it. They turned him around.
It was really hard. I think the toughest part was leaving all my family.
And the fourth time at night in dark seas, and high waves heard a splash. So somebody was overboard, and he said, I'm going to save him, jumped in.
Somebody fell the boat. I didn't know who it was.
And Fernandez, all of 15, decided that he was best equipped to save whoever it was.
So I jumped in the water, and I was trying to get to who it was. And when I got close, I saw it was my mom. So that was pretty, like, shocked. I was like, oh, wow.
They made it to Mexico and then flew to Miami, and the rest is history.
Just recently turned 21-year-old José Fernández
putting on another spectacular show.
I was worrying about every 5 days going out there to do my thing.
Wow! Fernández has won his 12th game and has given Marlins fans great hope for the future.
I give everything that I got and give my team a chance to win. That was my goal.
14 strikeouts, a Marlins rookie record. The defector, just dominant. Mom loves it.
You know, I look in the stands and I see my mom. I don't like to get tattooed something that it doesn't mean anything to me. I got my initials there and the two love of my life. I got my mom's name and my grandma's name. And my mom doesn't know as much about baseball as my grandma. My grandma is a baseball freak.
If you could, you know, send her a message in Cuba, what would you say to her?
You know, everything that I do is for her, and she knows I'm just gonna be, wanna keep working hard, and hopefully one day she's gonna get to see me here.
How are you? Bueno?
Having watched the dynamic unfold with him caring about his grandmother so much, kind of came to our attention here, and we have a big family here in this organization, and there was a link missing in that family.
My pleasure. Yes. My pleasure.
So we closed the gap. We got her here.
Jose knows nothing.
No, nothing.
Niente.
Nothing.
Nada.
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 What do you think she would say if she was here? What would she tell you?
I don't think she will be here.
I think he'll be so stunned he won't know what to do.
You gotta be kidding me. No. Oh man, this is stop it. This is not. When this happened? Ah, we won't be at.
Ahorita. Media hora que llegué. Tú estás precioso, papi. Precioso, precioso.
¿Qué te quedas flaco tú?
Sí.
No. No estás llorando aquí. This is, oh my God, how, this
I've
is.
I've never seen you speechless.
No, yeah, stop for me. Oh my God.
You know, this is better than being the big leagues, better than winning anything for me.
I wanted to show her everything that I did during the season, that she couldn't be with me everywhere that I was, how, what I did. Oh, baby, she will catch it, she will catch it.
A medio de la voy a tirar.
Duro.
She teach me how to cash.
She taught you?
Yeah, when I was little, I would come back from practice and she would be like, no, no, no. Pull your hands down, keep your glove down, and you look at the ball until you get to your glove. All every day she would work with me. Vamos afuera para que tire. Para que tire donde yo tire este año. ¿Quieres tirar desde aquí? ¿Ah? Alejo.
First time in National League voting for the Jackie Robinson Rookie of the Year Award, a Cuban-born player is the winner. The Marlins pitcher, José Fernández, got 26 of the 30 first-place votes.
Yeah, a lot of bicycle riding for José Fernández to get in great shape. Yeah, spring training numbers were okay. Breaking ball. Got him. Major League trivia question is, what National League catcher led the league in home run?
One out singles. José snares it.
Wow. Yay. He's locked in.
98 miles an hour. With one out, it was Michael Kadire and Carlos Gonzalez. That's a check swing and a swing.
Center fielders in particular.
Blackman can't hold the
hitting streak last year.
Got him. José Fernández strikes out the side.
And had an ERA of 1.19.
And he gets Tulowitzki for the second time.
Marlins live. And he said it just the way I was thinking as far as opening days. Just strikeout number 8.
We'll have a little more wins in the win column. A home run by Carlos Gonzalez, a sharp breaking ball by José Fernández, and thus the top of the 6th is over.
José, today you become the youngest Marlins pitcher to start on opening day, and you do it with your family here, your grandmother in the stands. What was this day like for you?
You know, it was really amazing. Having an incredible time, you know, having them in the stands. When I was walking in from the bullpen, I blew him a kiss, and, you know, it's really special to have her there. I mean, she hasn't seen me pitch for a really long time, so I want to see what she's going to tell me that I did wrong now.
I don't think a whole lot. 6 innings, just the 1 run. But you seemed to settle down a little bit after the first. Was there anything that felt different after that first inning?
You know, I just did it. I went out there and I didn't want to be overthrowing it and doing all that stuff. So I was basically trying to throw strikes and you know, try to get outs and try to get quick outs and you know, try to get my team inside to hit it. And that's what I was trying to. But I mean, I think that, you know, we're hitting the ball incredible. You know, it's fun. Got 7 runs and we're winning, so really excited about it today.
Yeah, nice to get that run support in the first start of the year for you. How important was this game? I know it's just one game, but you had such a tremendous rookie year. How important is it to be able to come out and set the precedent of the type of pitcher you're going to be in year 2?
You know what? I think it's just fun. And you know, having Salty behind the plate, wow, you know, incredible. He did an incredible game. Ozuna hitting the ball, and everybody, McGee, everybody hitting the ball well. So, you know, really excited I got a chance to be out there, represent my team and represent my fans. They were going crazy out there, so thank you.
All right, José, thank you so much. Glad you enjoyed opening
day. Thank you.
Guys.
Very nice job. Thanks for José for the interview during the game. Olga on the right, Mom on the left. Olga, the abuela, who was one of the guiding lights in José's life, his young life in Cuba, but when he escaped and came to the United States at a young age, he had to leave her behind. His mom was with him. Remember, his mother fell into the sea. This was the third attempt. José was the one that dove in, not knowing that that was his mother, and rescued her. So Mom made it with José. They relocated to Tampa. But last year, his grandmother had to climb to the top of their house, her house, to get the Marlins Spanish radio broadcast in Cuba, and would listen every time José pitched. This was the off season. The Marlins arranged for a 2-year visa for Olga to come to the United States, and she arrived in the United States just as José was getting his Rookie of the Year award. And of course, many of you have seen the moving video when the Marlins surprised José with his grandmother, a warm embrace.
Well, it's happened again. Not even 2 months into the season, and already we're up to our 16th pitcher who looks like he's going to need Tommy John surgery. And this time, it's a big blow for baseball. José Fernández, the Marlins' reigning Rookie of the Year pitcher and one of the few young gate attractions the Marlins could count on, has an elbow injury that's going to send him to the disabled list and possibly under the knife, ending his second Major League season far sooner than anybody anticipated.
I went into the game knowing that my arm wasn't right, you know, well, with a pain in my elbow, but I didn't think that was a big deal. And I went in the third inning, I think, and I was talking to Shine, the video guy, and I told him, hey, I'm done. He goes, what do you mean you're done? I was like, yeah, I'm done for the season. My elbow is done. So when I went back out, I tried to pitch, and you know, and I couldn't. So I was hoping for the best, but I knew there was not going to be good news. When I went to see the doctor goes to me, and you know, whatever, we're talking, and I'm thinking 4 to 6 weeks, 6 to 8 weeks, by hoping. And you know, the doctor comes back to me, and he explains to me everything, the medicine, you know, like the medicine terms, and I'm like, all right, you want to talk to me in English now? So because I have no idea what you're saying. So he goes, basically, if I was you, I would do Tommy John. So I was standing up, and I just freeze, didn't say anything, and I said, excuse me, you know, went to the restroom. I looked to myself in the mirror, and tears were coming out of my eyes. It was really, really tough to hear. I think one of the hardest things that, happened to me in my life so far. I like to write down, and I like to see where I'm going towards my goals, and I like to write down my goals. You know, and July 2nd was a day that I liked for no reason. Day that the doctor, the team, everybody was happy with. And I think that I think hopefully it's going to be a really special day. I consider myself a big, big team guy. I'm all about this team. I give my heart for this team. Every 5 days I go out there and give everything that I have for this team. I wanted to be here, but at the same time, it was really tough. It was really tough to see the guys battling out there, being so close to the race and being there. And just, I was in the dugout just watching. So it was really painful for me to be there and watch them. But at the same time, that's what I wanted to do. Pitching here in Miami is, what can I say? It's the best place. It's the best place that I pitch at. You know, the numbers never lie, like I say. But I think that pitching here is just amazing, man. I feel the love from the fans. I feel the support, and it's just, I like to compete. You know, I like to show them that it is possible. It is possible to accomplish your dreams, and it is possible to be whoever you want to be in life.
Congratulations on being the newest United States citizen. Congratulations.
Every day when I wake up and I look around me and I know that I'm free, I think that's a dream. That's a dream that I had, and that's why I came to this country.
Every time I hear it, by the end part, I'm talking about freedom.
Llamando, bongo,
we saw in spring training. You're going to see high velocity. You're going to see him keeping that fastball down, and you're going to see him be able to put away hitters different ways. It's going to be tougher on them facing this power righty.
0-2 pitch, 98 miles an hour. And welcome to 2016, Jose Fernandez. Fernandez struck Ian Kinsler out swinging, and he gets Upton swinging. Three hitters, three strikes.
Was hit into the home run sculpture.
Fernandez into inning number three. And a fastball, he pumps it by Sanchez. So five strikeouts, first time through the order. An all-star every other year, all in those even years. Good luck spelling Bavacqua. Fastball, swing and a miss. Jose. Oh, wow. Jose, sharp break on the slider. And just like that, he has struck out five in a row.
The whole stadium in playing condition.
Jose Fernandez has nine strikeouts. That is strikeout number.
Those pitches are in no way the same.
Outside corner, Jose Fernandez. 1-2. Check swing, went around. And that is strikeout number 12. Swing and a miss. Tied him up. That slider, I don't know if it backed up, but it almost came in down on the hands.
Scratch run.
Yeah.
Jose Fernandez, Barry Bonds, found the cameras.
Oh my God. Jose Fernandez is always chewing off Barry Bonds here. It's unbelievable how much those two chat.
Protects 99. Couple. One of the great hitters that ever lived, one of the great young arms in the game right now. And Barry's got Jose rolling.
I think that's one of the things that people are starting to understand about Barry Bonds. Now, Barry Bonds is not the Barry Bonds when he played. I've always had a great relationship with him, but he's funny, he's thoughtful. He's one of the guys that what you remember or what people know of the image that he had when he played, he's nothing like that. These players love him. He'll come back on the plane and sit with us for an hour doing a plane ride. Just come back and sit to the back of the plane and come talk to us. Like,
I think he's saying that Jose Fernandez won't stop talking.
Yeah, that's all the time. That's all the time. He's always, like, he can't get away from it. It's like his kid, man.
It's his coordinated blowing a kiss. All right. Comes a 2-2 to Hazelbaker. And a bouncing ball to short. Miami hands St. Louis its largest loss of the season, 11-0.
All right, let's do this. Let's meet the National League All-Star team. First, name to the coaching staff from your San Diego Padres, Andy Green. Arizona Diamondbacks, Paul Goldschmidt. From the Atlanta Braves, Julio Teheran. From the Chicago Cubs, Dexter Fowler. John Lester. Corey Seager.
Clayton Kershaw. Embrace it. And Kenley Jansen. From the Miami Marlins, Jose Fernandez. AJ Ramos. And Fernando Rodney.
Starting an inning, trying to get it out.
Strikeout ends the inning. Two homers in it.
Depending on the situation.
Here is a one-out walk. He points out, smiles at the young one. We'll see if that's it. And it is.
¡Gracias!
tierra.
For Jose, and a first pitch swing and a busted fat needle. He slowly hit and has to hurry, and he does quickly have Bryce Harper in the
Si acaso no regreso, yo me llevo tu bandera, lamentando que mis ojos liberada no te viera. Porque tuve que marcharme, todos pueden comprender. Pensé que en cualquier momento a tu suelo iba a volver. Pero el tiempo va pasando y tu sol sigue llorando. Las cadenas siguen atando, pero yo sigo esperando y al cielo rezando. Y siempre me sentí dichosa de haber nacido entre tus brazos. Guardaremos los rencores, Dios mío, y compartiremos todos un mismo sentimiento. Aunque el tiempo haya pasado, con orgullo y dignidad, tu nombre lo he llevado, a todo el mundo entero le he contado tu verdad. Pero tierra, ya no sufras, corazón, no te quebrantes, no. No hay mal que dure 100 años, ni cuerpo que aguante. Y nunca quise abandonarte, te llevaba en cada paso. Y llevará mi amor para siempre como flor en tu regazo, por si acaso. No regreso.
now to the tragic loss of rising baseball star José Fernández.
We begin with José Fernández.
José Fernández, a defector from Cuba, was one of three people found dead after the accident in Miami. As Andrew Spencer reports, his death has shocked the Major League Baseball community.
When you watch kids play Little League or something like that, that's the joy that José played with.
Miami Marlins manager Don Mattingly choked up talking about the death of his ace pitcher, José Fernández, and he wasn't the only one to have trouble speaking.
Now he's gone, and it's hard.
It is hard.
It's a tremendous loss, and my heart goes out to his family.
Fernández posted this picture of his pregnant girlfriend on Instagram just 5 days ago, with the caption, "I'm so glad you came into my life. I'm ready for where this journey is going to take us together." A Cuban defector who moved to the United States at the age of 15, Fernandez's talent quickly made him a star in the big leagues. Early Sunday morning, not long after 3 a.m., a Coast Guard patrol found a 32-foot boat upside down on a rocky jetty.
It does appear that speed was involved due to the impact and the severity of it. It does appear to be that they were coming at full speed when they encountered the jetty and the accident happened.
Three men in their 20s were found dead, one on the rocks and two in the water. Officials would later identify one of those men as 24-year-old José Fernández. The other two were his personal friends. Andrew Spencer, Fox 4, in your corner.
The Marlins canceling their game today against the Atlanta Braves after learning the heartbreaking news. But at games throughout the country and one in Toronto, players, officials, and fans all taking a moment to stand in silence to honor Fernández. The Marlins Stadium having some special tributes to remember him on the scoreboard and on the field as fans showed up throughout the day, leaving flowers and mementos.
Difficult day in Miami. For Marlins fans, even for Met fans, for baseball fans, Marlins Park. This about 3 hours ago, Dee Gordon with José's glove and José Fernández cap and a baseball. Tonight, the Marlins will play a baseball game just 36 hours from learning that they had lost their ace. Hi, everybody. I'm Rich Waltz, along with Al Leiter. You see the emotion in the Marlins players' faces. It's the Marlins and the Mets tonight, and certainly we have a ball game to cover. But this night begins and ends with a discussion of José Fernández. And 48 hours ago, Al, we saw him in terms of strikeouts, of Rookie of the Year, of All-Star appearances. And now none of that is talked about. Now, in the last 48 hours, all that is talked about is the person, the journey, and the impact of José Fernández.
Yeah, the story of José Fernández, you're right, Rich. And I think about José Fernández as the person. Of course, you know, the baseball stuff is going to really play out for what he was as a young player, 24 years old, and looked like he was destined for a future Hall of Fame type thing. But what struck me is when I heard the news, you know, early what Saturday, I thought about really what transpired in his life and how he touched so many people beyond players on his team, beyond being the heart and soul and spirit of that club. He really was. At moments like this, it's so genuine and so meaningful for a kid who was 24 years old but acted way beyond those years. His laugh, his joy, his enthusiasm, it was just really something that I'll never forget, the time and interaction that I've had with José.
A los pies de la Virgen de la Caridad para dar gracias a Dios por la vida de este hermano nuestro. Oremos por su descanso eterno y oremos por sus seres queridos.
Well, you can hear the crowd right now. All Marlin players are wearing not only number 16 but also a jersey with Fernández on the back. And as you would expect, it's an emotional scene here in Miami, and it's hard. It's hard to watch a Yelich or a Stanton with tears in their eyes moments before a major league game.
they grew up with Jose. I mean, you know, just had a chance to talk to Christian Yelich before, and, you know, he's like, Al, I've known him since I first started. Like, this isn't just teammates that, you know, you just fall off as a big leaguer and you have this infectious personality that's in the clubhouse and in the dugout and amazing on the field. They grew up together. Many of these guys down here, they're friends, dinner, hanging out, going over to each other's house. This is way beyond just wearing a uniform and logos and marks of a major league team.
Of course, Marlins Park sits right in the middle of Little Havana, a spot in an area where Jose Fernandez had so much impact. Let's start our night here at Marlins Park down on the field.
Nuestra comunidad, el mundo del béisbol y la familia de los Miami Marlins sufrió una trágica pérdida ayer con la muerte de José Fernández. Estamos reunidos aquí esta noche como una familia con nuestros corazones llenos de dolor para recordar un hombre y pelotero que significó tanto para todos nosotros. Lo mantendremos en nuestros corazones para siempre.
Our community, the baseball world, and the Miami Marlins suffered a tragic loss yesterday with the passing of Jose Fernandez. Our hearts are heavy with sorrow as we gather today, together tonight, as a family to remember a man and a teammate who meant so much to all of us. We shall keep him in our hearts forever, and please bow your head and reflect with a moment of silence. Please remain standing and remove your caps as we honor our country with our colors and national anthem. Presenting the colors this evening is the Honor Guard from the Navy JROR2TC unit at G. Holmes Braddock Senior High School in Miami. And here to perform the Star Spangled Banner for us this evening is the Carrollton Choir.
Oh, say can
And the Marlins converge on the diamond, shaking hands, hugging, high fives. The staffs from both teams, the umpires, all out there on this field. What a moving tribute to Jose.
Now, this was supposed to be Jose Day. Jose was supposed to be on the mound for the Marlins tonight. Jose will not be on the mound, but he is here with us in this ballpark tonight. You can feel it. It was quite a scene when the Marlins players lined up in front of the third base dugout for the national anthem. The eight starting position players each jogged out toward the field, and as Jose does prior to every start, and it's going to take a while to not talk about Jose in the present tense. As Jose does prior to every start, they kicked at that third base foul line, reached down, grabbed a handful of dirt, and headed out to the mound. And four on the third base side of the mound, four on the first base side of the mound, with a big gaping hole in the middle. Eight Marlins, not nine, taking the field tonight here at Marlins Park. As the Marlins return to baseball following the tragic loss of Jose Fernandez. And now the Marlins players are gathering in a circle off to the third base side of the pitcher's mound as a few final handshakes and hugs are completed between some Marlins players and Mets players. Adam Conley, who will pitch tonight's game, is making his way into the dugout from the right field bullpen. And all the Marlins players staying out there on the field right now as the Mets head back to the first base dugout. What an unbelievable scene. And that's a spontaneous display of sportsmanship, of brotherhood, of respect, of love. Marlins players hugging each other. And Dave was right. This is a very quiet ballpark tonight. And it's going to be a quiet ballpark throughout the night between innings instead of the normal in-game entertainment. We're going to see pictures of Jose on the board. Now all the Marlins players walk to the pitcher's mound. And will drop to a knee, and many of them tapping the number 16 painted at the back of the mound, many writing Jose's initials along the edge of the mound. The entire Marlins roster, all the players, all the coaches have circled that mound now. And now a moment of prayer. He is not on the mound tonight. But Jose Fernandez very much with us here at Marlins Park. And I've got to say, for a Monday night, game 156, this is a larger than normal turnout at Marlins Park, which is great to see, as now all the Marlins players embrace near the pitcher's mound. They gather in a big, tight circle. Now, Carlos Stanton is saying something to the entire team. They had a team meeting before batting practice today where many of the players got up and spoke. It was a very emotional scene. There were a lot of tears shed. And one of the themes, as Don Mattingly expressed it, was Jose Fernandez would want us to go out there and play hard. And it's a tearful Giancarlo Stanton now pointing his finger to the sky, and the rest of the Marlins join him.
Tears streaming down Giancarlo's face. The last Met to leave the field was Yoenis Cespedes, engaged in several long, emotional moments with several of the Marlins players.
Well, it was in New York yesterday before the final game of the Mets series against the Phillies that Jeff Wilpon, their chief operating officer, went into the trainer's room pregame, and he spoke with Yoenis Cespedes and Asdrubal Cabrera, and he said, "We have made up a number 16 Fernandez Mets jersey, and what do you guys think? We'd like to maybe display it in the dugout today." Cespedes said, "Please give it to me. I want to take it out there myself." He taped it up in the Mets dugout at Citi Field yesterday, And that number 16 Mets José Fernández jersey is hanging in the Mets dugout here at Marlins Park tonight. As you can talk all you want about pennant races and rivalries, this is a brotherhood. And when a team loses a brother, everybody in this sport has lost a brother. And this is not one that anybody on the Marlins side or anywhere in baseball is going to get over this anytime soon. Just an absolutely tragic loss.
And you can feel in this ballpark the emotion, and not just from players, from the fans as well.
The broadcasters, by the way.
We, yes, are experiencing that. And JT Realmuto came out to accept the warm-up pitches from Adam Conley, and he stopped at the very back of the dirt circle at home plate, behind the plate, of course. And he used his right forefinger and wrote, "Be with God, José 16.
Now, it's easy to forget this, but this is a very important baseball game for the Mets, who have a magic number of 6 to clinch a wild card spot. And the Marlins are still mathematically alive, so they have something on the line here as well. The odds are incredibly long, and we've said that for the last week or so. It will take a miracle and then some. But there is a baseball game, and that business at hand. I do think, Dave, as we get set for the first pitch tonight, though, this may not be your typical Major League Baseball broadcast. And if folks are tuning in to hear play-by-play of every pitch and all the stats and stories, this may not be the night for that, because the stories we talk about tonight with the two of us, some guests will join us, are going to be about José Fernández.
They are that. The Conley first pitch of the night is over for a strike, and the game is underway with José Reyes against Adam Conley. And a comebacker to the mound. Conley has that, throws to first for the out. I really think, Jeff, based on what we've witnessed here in the pregame, the last few moments, players coming out, lining up, the moment of silence, the anthem, the visuals on Marlins Vision, and then the emotional meeting of the two teams, I think it's going to take these players 1, 2, 3, 4 innings to really get into the flow of the game, each in his own way. It'll take some longer than others to get focused on baseball. A pitch to Cabrera, laced through the right side, and a base hit from Asdrubal Cabrera that'll bring Yoenis Cespedes to the plate. As I mentioned moments ago, and then Geff followed that up with the story of Cespedes putting the number 16 Met jersey with José's last name on the back of it up in the Met dugout yesterday, bringing that with him to Marlins Park, and it's up in the Mets dugout. And Cespedes, during that pregame, was as emotional as anyone down there. Here's the pitch, and a called strike.
Every Marlins player is wearing a Fernandez 16 black jersey. The folks at Majestic, who make the Major League uniforms, worked all night last night to produce these jerseys, and they flew them down here themselves today.
A high pop-up on the right side of the infield that the first baseman, Justin Bohr, will take care of for out number two with Cabrera at first base. Cespedes is out. It's impossible to get into the head of each and every player, Geff, to know exactly how they're feeling. But they're going through a very unusual process right now. Mourning. The extreme emotion shown pregame, and now try to refocus on a baseball game. There's a called strike. And probably each one in his own way, thinking about how José not only enjoyed every single moment on the field, in the dugout, in the clubhouse, every single moment he experienced in baseball, but was also a very focused, determined, and highly competitive pitcher. And I think that they'll all remind themselves of that. We're going to do this for José tonight. There's a ball fouled away down the left side.
you often hear baseball people say that when times are tough, those 3 hours a night between the white lines, that's your sanctuary, and that's where you can go, and things are much easier out there. I'm not sure that tonight is one of those nights, though.
No, I would agree with you. When this game started, just 32 hours and a few minutes since the announcement, and very difficult for the players and everyone in the baseball community everywhere to deal with. But particularly here at Marlins Park and in Miami, where the pain is felt more severely than anywhere else. Foul ball back. 0-2 on Curtis Granderson. Granderson hitting in the cleanup spot for the New York Mets. There's a lot at stake in these final games for these Mets. Right now, the New York Mets, here's the pitch, and a ball sliced in the air to left. Coming in on it is Ozuna, and makes the catch. So for Adam Conley, and we'll get to him in a moment, but Curtis Granderson lines out. Right-handed. I'm going to guess that he had Jose's helmet, because after he took that first Bartolo Colon pitch, he changed helmets and went to his side, the left side of the batter.
After the game, about God, if you could, what was it you said to them?
I told them, I said, man, if y'all don't believe in God, y'all need to start, because they've been with me for 2 years and they ain't never seen me hit a ball up there.
Thank you.
home run truck.